Good morning, students. Welcome back to our science class. Today we will discuss about the energy resource of Earth are limited. Okay. When we talk about exhaustible energy resources, which means the resources which are present in a limited stock, we need to manage these resources because we have to make it available to the future generation as well. We know that the energy that we use today comes from three main resources of air, which are coal, petroleum and natural gases are the main sources of energy. And the amount of these coal, petroleum and natural gas present in the earth are limited. These fossil fuels are present in the earth in a limited stock. So once the stock gets exhausted, once the stock of these fossil fuels exhausted or finished, there will be no new supplies for these fossil fuels, because we know that the formation of fossil fuels takes millions and millions. So we need to use the fossil fuels with the care and not waste. And another thing is, the burning of fossil fuel is a major source of air pollution. The burning of fossil fuels causes air pollution and it will lead to a phenomenon called global warming. What do you mean by global warming? Actually, global warming means a rapid increase in the temperature in the earth, and it is due to the release of greenhouse gas, which is carbon dioxide. Greenhouse gas is carbon dioxide, and the burning of fossil fuels leads to the release of greenhouse gas, carbon dioxide, which will lead to global warming. Global warming means a rapid increase in the temperature of the earth. Okay, I will repeat it once again. We know that exhaustible energy resources means the energy resources that are present in the limited stock. Most of the energy that we use today comes from three main resources of air, that are coal, petroleum and natural gas. But the amount of coal, petroleum and natural gas present in the earth are limited. They are present in a limited stock. Once the stock of these fossil fuels are exhausted or finished, there will be no further new supply for these fossil fuels, because we know that the formation of fossil fuels takes millions and millions years. That means the formation of fossil fuel is not an easy process. It takes millions and millions. So we need to use the fossil fuels in a limited quantity, or we have to use the fossil fuels with more care and caution. And another thing is, the burning of fossil fuel is a major source of air pollution. The burning of fossil fuels causes air pollution and it will lead to a phenomenon called global warming. What do you mean by global warming? Global warming means a sudden increase in the temperature of the air, and which is due to the release of greenhouse gas called carbon dioxide. Greenhouse gas is carbon dioxide. Due to the formation of this greenhouse gas, the temperature of our air will increase. That is, the burning of fossil fuels leads to the release of greenhouse gas carbon dioxide, and this will further leads to the global warming. Okay. So here the point is, we should reduce or minimize the use of fossil fuels, or we should use it with more care and caution, because it will ensure the availability of fossil fuels for a longer period of time. That means when we minimize the use of fossil fuels, then it will be available to the future generation. And second point, it will reduce the air pollution. We know that the burning of fossil fuels causes air pollution. When we minimize the use of fossil fuels, it will reduce the air pollution and leads to a cleaner environment. And next one, it will reduce the risk of global warming. Global warming means a rapid increase in the temperature of the air. When we reduce the use of fossil fuels, it will reduce the risk of global warming. Okay, and one more thing is we can't prepare fossil fuels in laboratory from dead organism, because the formation of fossil fuel is a very, very slow process and we can't create a situation or a condition for their formation in the laboratory. So we should use the fossil fuels with more care and caution. Next one is how to save petrol and diesel. We know that petrol and diesel are the two main fuels here used for driving vehicles, right? And here we are discussing about the various tips for minimizing the wastage of petrol and diesel while driving. First one is drive vehicles at a constant and moderate speed. And second one, switch off the vehicle's engine at traffic lights. And third one is ensure correct air pressure in the tires of the vehicles, because low air pressure consumes more fuels. And last one is ensure regular maintenance of the vehicles. These are the various tips for minimizing the wastage of petrol and diesel. All the fossil fuels are exhaustible, because that means they are present in a limited stock. So we should use it with more care and caution. So this is for our today's class. I hope all of you understood this chapter. Thank you.